Hey, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to learn how to do multiple selection, date selection. And you know, when you're using jQuery, I got some quotes from Google. Then I said I'm going to do what? To customize them and make what I want. So here you're gonna link to your bootstrap date picker. So once you got that, here we're gonna do what? Link to our CSS also. You get me? You need these two, these 1, 2, 3 lines. You're gonna get them. Okay, it's fine. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna also put a link whereby you're gonna get that full code of this, so you will just copy and paste it and start running. You understand? That's the thing. So it took me some days to figure out what to do this, how to do this. So I'm not that good in jQuery or JavaScript, but anyway, if you're a programmer, you can fight until you get your stuff work. So now what is the issue here? To we did try to see that. Let me try to run this. There are a couple of options. I'm gonna do things in a different way, not the way you know. Once you click here, you can get 1, 2, 1, 2. When you select, you can see it only selects one, doesn't select anything else. Okay, so only all that you do it in jQuery. What you do, you have to customize your JavaScript there, and it gonna give you what you need. You can even see like today highlight. If I say false, it won't. False. Okay, if I say false, it won't highlight today's date. But if I say true, it's gonna highlight. There are a couple of things you can do there to modify. Okay, you can see there's no today's date, and today's date is the 12th. You can see now it doesn't select it. So that's the thing I'm showing you, that there are many tricks. All the science is done here. So say true. Okay, you're gonna look into some of the functions you have to use. You see that it's easier to do that. When I do this, you can see I get a very beautiful thing. So when I click on select, I only select what I've selected. I'm gonna show you something else. I'm gonna say after selection, auto close is gonna be yes, true, which is true. I'm just showing you, we're going to what you need. But why I'm showing you this, because I don't want you to now to do what? To select a date, your dates, like now I'm selecting. When I select, it goes off. So I want to see, I'm selecting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever. Then I scroll on, I select more. Then it won't give me any trouble. Okay, that's cool. So that's fine. So once I get that, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to make that to be false. Why? Because whenever I want to select, I want to see what I selected. Though whatever I'm gonna select is gonna go into our text box, but it doesn't mean I should leave my calendar go. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna save that, and I come here and I say okay. Once I select, whenever I select nothing, the calendar doesn't go away, so I can also go here and select whatever. Okay, now it's time to jump into what we came in here for. So, but also those tricks, don't forget them. They're gonna help you to maintain your calendar look professional, and it won't give you any problems. So you need two things here, but we need one thing. But the second thing, all those are extras I'm trying to show you. Okay, first of all, we need what they call, we have to put in here something like the format. Which format do you want? Can you see that if you don't put in a format, this is the format you get? It starts with a what? Let me go here. I'm selecting here. It starts with a month, it goes to the date, then gets you the year. So we wanna fix that. We wanna get the format before we get what we need. So here I'm gonna go inside here and I say format. After when you say format, you know I'm writing it in the wrong way, format, then put semicolon in, space, double quote, you put a comma here. Inside here, I want to start with the year myself. Y, four Ys, dash, I wanted my dash to look like this. I want a month, mm, then I want what they call a day. After that, I'm going to save here, and I go straight here, and I refresh, and you can see that if I select, I get 2020-12-02. You can see, that's fine. If I go to 2021, I go 2021, whatever. So now, what is next? Once we're done with that, just know that we're going to the next step, which is going to be the most exciting step. So, I'm going to explain here. A couple of guys, they use another function here. You can see we use the DatePicker as we use the DatePicker here, but some guys don't use the DatePicker. So, you can see we use the DatePicker function, but now them, they use date multiple something. Multiple date picker, you understand, like that. But I don't use that. I'm gonna give you something simple which we have to use here on what you have, using converting that your single selection date picker to a multiple selection. So now what you do, we put here something small. We say multi date, okay, space, then you say true. You say true. After that, you're gonna save. After saving, you know that, okay, I'm done. Let's see if that's gonna work for me. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see, guys, everything is working perfectly. So analyze the code, analyze this, you see what is going on here before we proceed. You understand? Can you see what is going on? Okay, I guess you've seen here. Since you've seen that, I'm gonna do what? I'm gonna go and explain to you what we need to know. You can see everything is working perfect. I'm gonna just explain to you something simple here. Okay, we're done with that. So even if I go to 2021 and I select my date and select my date, it will add on all the dates I have selected. You can see. So since I've selected all these dates, I'm gonna then grab them and do whatever I want to do that. So even if I select 1,000 of them, I can do that. So once I've done, you can see each and every date, there's a comma. You get me? So since there's a comma on everything, then we do what? We do gonna go to the code and show you. So once you put multi-date only, this is gonna help you. So multi-date is gonna help you to do only that. This we just put it because we wanted the format, but if you don't want this format, you can change the format to whatever you want it to be. You understand? So now that's one of the reason why we put this. So guys, you can use your normal date picker and convert it to multiple selection. You get me? As you've seen, we select and you don't need anything else. It's gonna put for you a comma. You just only have to write multi-date, then you say true. Once you're done with that, then you're gonna be pretty fine to do whatever you want. You get me, guys? Yeah, guys, I think we should conclude our tutorial. If you did not understand anything, please tell me. And I'm gonna do what? I'm gonna help you also do more stuff if you failing to do stuff. But I promise you, I'm gonna put this code, the modified one, into our website. Then you're gonna go there and get it. I got this code, the entire code, from another website, but then I did customize it to manage to show you this is what how it gone. I didn't build the whole code. I only managed to manipulate here to show you that it's possible to use these here, guys. Yes, guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. This is Azania Tutorials. I hope this has helped you guys, and see you in the next video.